another good friend of mine, Miss Kai Norte from Kubé Ice Cream. Kubé Nice Cream, I just say, forgive me, Kubé Nice Cream. Not Kubé Ice Cream, but Kubé Nice Cream, a plant-based coconut ice cream. So we're happy. Always great to see you, Miss Kai. And yes. I know you're going to share your beautiful story. And so this, we're going to give you the stage and you can take it off from here.
Okay. So my name is Kai Norte, and I'm the CEO and co-founder of Kubé Nice Cream. And Kubé is a Black woman-led vegan ice cream manufacturing facility in Oakland, California. And we are producing the most authentic and best tasting non-dairy coconut ice cream. Actually, this is so important. I just have to time myself real quick here. Yes. So going on, that means that we crack and we shred mature coconuts with patent pending equipment and automatic coconut machinery that is arriving here very soon. We're super excited. And so we take that beautiful cold pressed cream, then we blend with plant-based flavors that are bold, organic, and just super vibrant. And people can't get enough of Kubé. They're like, how did you get this flavor, this coconut flavor out? And I'm like, I didn't get it out. They're like, this is so bold in flavor. They're just so excited to purchase Kubé. And so what we're really doing is building the next inclusive and regenerative economy, because we have all these really cool byproducts. But before I get into that, I'm going to just tell you a little bit about myself. So as a child, as you can see, I'm here, my son is here. But when I was a child, I grew up with a huge organic vegetable and fruit garden in Oakland, California. I think that was like the blessing, seriously, because it was where I was able to have these real cool discussions with my mom, my brothers, about the discovery of the truth, right? And really discovering that our compost, right, made this really cool regenerative soil that had all these nutrients in it that allowed us to have really good kale, collard greens, zucchini, blackberries, apple trees. And that was where I had real discussions about, you know, the mama earth seed that actually grows into more seeds, right? Or more fruit that actually regenerates into more seeds and more food compared to the GMO seeds, I say, of death, right? And so I'm teaching my son, you see him, he's here watering the collard greens. And this is so important because children are the messengers of an unknown future. But if we teach them how imperative it is to build the next inclusive and regenerative, full circle regenerative economy that restores life, health, dignity, joy, right? Equity, right? Back to people, back to the soil, back to the ocean. These things are really important. And lastly, I come from an interdisciplinary background in biology, in business development. I have a master's in marketing communications. But coming back full circle, this is where we talked about what regenerative food systems, right here with what I'm doing with my son. And so the problem is, when you're talking about regenerative food systems, you realize that not everybody is regenerative, right? Like there's a lot of agrochemicals, and that's why the food system is broken, because we still see that there are companies out there using synthetic chemicals. So all the coconut ice cream on the market and in the can, whether it's organic or not organic, has synthetic chemicals called sodium metabisulfite, which is a toxic bleaching chemical that causes gastrointestinal issues and hormonal issues in people. And the FDA says that these companies don't have to list it in the ingredients. However, there are some cans, as you see here, that will state that there is sodium metabisulfite. Now, people want the future, and the future is now. And Kubé is building the next regenerative an inclusive future with vibrant, clean, fresh, plant-based ice cream. And so our customers are really a mixture of flexitarians who eat dairy, but they still want non-dairy ice cream, or they want really Kubé because our flavors are so bold and bright. Our other customers are the lactose intolerant population. You know, 90% of Africans of the diaspora are lactose intolerant. 90% of Asians are lactose intolerant. 70% of Eastern Europeans are also lactose intolerant. And about 52% of Mexican Americans, Latinx folks are lactose intolerant. So you see the list goes on and on. And here it's important to realize that people want what we're making. They want this every day. So when we sell online, we're selling online right now. And when people have this, we're selling out 80% of our inventory. So we make 1,000 units, and then we ask people on social media to come purchase this. And they're realizing that they just want more and more. So our value proposition is really that we're building new inclusive and regenerative food models that restore life and health back to people, the soil, animals. So I talked about in the ocean. So I just talked about that, the fact that we have all this byproduct, this soil resource, which is the coconut shreds, and we give that to urban farms. But we're going to upcycle that and start selling that very soon to other urban farms that really understand the value of our compost, our byproducts. And so this is really important because we're really talking about creating jobs, creating locally resilient jobs and vegan ice cream manufacturing that is grounded in racial and gender equity, grounded in climate justice, right? And this is why we're switching from the cup with a plastic lid to glass. This is a $1.25 billion industry, and we need new leaders of the future. Kubé is that new leader, of building the next inclusive and regenerative economy. And we just secured a 5,000 square foot facility in Oakland in the Embarcadero. I'm really excited, y'all, because we've been like trapped in this commercial kitchen for like 2 years, and it's been very challenging to meet demand. And so what we're really talking about is building local jobs here. We've already secured this location. It will be a storefront in the front and manufacturing in the back. And people want to have coconut ice cream, our Kubé coconut ice cream, in various bold plant-based flavors in the actual halved coconut. And they want it in glass jars, really sexy, sophisticated glass jars. So this is what we're doing for the future, y'all. Thank you so much.
What amazing job as always, Ms. Kai.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see the future. I know you have a bright future. So please stay on. And okay, we're going to have a few questions. Our investor panel will come on. And your ice cream is definitely delicious. One of my favorites.
Oh, thank you. I think it's the key lime.
There you go. Absolutely.
I'm just really excited. Since the last time I heard from Kai, hearing the development and getting your new space set up. So specifically for the next, you know, we're in quarter four, which is a terrifying thought. What are your plans for this quarter? What are you looking at?
Oh, absolutely. I didn't have time to say it in there. So I'm really excited because we're going to be partnering with Zero Grocery in Berkeley, California. And so what they do is they're a distributor that delivers directly to customers, the health conscious climate justice consumers, in glass jars, y'all, in glass jars. That's all they do. So they're about closing the loop of single-use plastics, because 91% of the plastics in the ocean are due to the CPG food system. That's a problem, y'all. So we have to change that, right? And so we're going to be working with them to design out our glass jars. They work with a manufacturer. And so what they do is they actually deliver ice cream. Well, they don't deliver just yet, but they're really excited to work with us to be able to finally deliver customers ice cream. So they deliver food in glass jars, either in compostable materials and in stainless steel containers. And so this is really important. They are growing, and we want to work with suppliers who are on the same page of building that full circle regenerative economy. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to actually be hiring very, very soon and getting off of the plastic lid and paper cup to the jar, to the glass jar, very soon. And we need suppliers like them. We need to work with, distributors like them to supply our customers and other folks all over the Bay Area and in Los Angeles. And this is why we are currently, we have an offering, a term sheet, and we are selling non-voting preferred stock. And our raise that we're doing is $3 million. And who knows, it might take us 6 months to achieve that, or it might take a year. But we're very clear that we're getting so much traction, and we'll be obtaining more traction. So probably by, this is what I forgot to say. So we won't be in this manufacturing facility until April. It's being built out. We don't have to pay for the cost of the build out. We don't have to pay for 2 months of, we have 2 months of free rent, but this is a very unique situation and a blessing that we have found. So.
Well, I'll jump in. I'm already a proud investor, and I'm happy to up to the preferred stock round as well. I have, loved Kai since the minute I met her, and I'm so thrilled to see this organizing. And so what can we do to help this mission at this time?
Thank you. So right now we're trying to find the right values aligned investors. We'd love to talk about, we want shared partners. We want to share equity, and we want partners that have the same or similar values, right? And so it's about what you can invest. Our minimum investment is $100,000. If that's a little challenging, we can talk about that and talk about what that's going to help us do. Because right now, our the most critical issue for us is hiring folks. And we want to hire formerly incarcerated folks who are men and women and single mothers. We realize that we have to have both, you know, all genders of people, seriously, in this building kubé. And every, you know, we have ice cream enthusiasts and they're of all ethnicities. They're of all different genders. They're of all different backgrounds. And so I would love to have, you know, a discussion with you more and whoever else about what you're able to invest. And we can talk about it from there. But really, we need money now to hire, you know, and all the different insurance and permits that come with building the manufacturing facility. But that's another positive thing. We don't have to pay for the health permits, for the architecture. I mean, this is really going to put kubé on a visibility map locally, nationally, and internationally. People will be coming from all over the world to visit kubé because we want to be replicated in Ghana, in the Caribbean, and other parts of the world. So this is a huge opportunity, y'all. It's really happening.
Thank you so much, Kai.
Thank you. And thank you for your time. Thank you, everyone.